So 2044, that's a long way out. So
I suggest going to see this one.
Yeah. Right, exactly. So what do we need to know?
Yeah.
Okay, so this could be like a once in a lifetime thing for a lot of people to have the path of totality come so close to Baltimore. And when I say totality, it would be like you see the stars come out, the streetlights come on, and all that kind of stuff. We're not going to be in the path of totality here in Baltimore, but it's going to be close enough that you're going to get a pretty good show, I think. And so we're going to cover what we're going to see here in Baltimore. So there's the path of totality. That's where it'll go completely dark on April the 8th. And you can see it's pretty close to Baltimore. It's certainly within driving distance. It cuts through the eastern part of Ohio, western Pennsylvania, and up into New York State. And a lot of people have already rented all the hotel rooms along the path of totality to see this. And you could drive out to western Maryland and get pretty close to it. But like I said, we're going to get a fairly decent show here at home in Baltimore. It's not going to go completely dark, but this is what you can expect on April the 8th around Baltimore. You should start to notice the eclipse about 2:05 in the afternoon. It'll start before that, but you'll notice it going dark around 2:05 in the afternoon. And we could reach 88%, maybe 90% coverage here in the Baltimore Metro. That means 88% of the solar disk is going to be covered. So again, it won't go completely dark, but it'll look like maybe late evening. You might even see a few stars if the sky is clear. The peak coverage will happen around 3:21 in the afternoon on that month. It's a Monday, I think, and the eclipse will end at 4:33 in the afternoon. So this is a pretty big deal. Hopefully you'll get a chance to get out there and look at it. You can get all kinds of information on our website, WBILTV.com, where you can get the glasses and all the safety tips and things like that.